Having little sound effects automatically go off in your chat depending on what your viewers are actually sending just adds that little bit of fun, a little bit of uncertainty and interactivity into the mix of your stream. So when someone sends any chat messages that says yeah or okay in your stream, you can have a little John going on in the background like this.
Yeah!
Or like this.
Okay!
Without you having to do anything. G'day everyone, it's me, Drew, your friendly neighborhood mix it up ambassador, and today I'm going to show you how to set up some automatic sound effects depending on what your chat is actually talking about. So I'm not going to really faff about it so much. You know, you can like, comment, subscribe, and all that kind of stuff if you would like to support the channel, which would be greatly appreciated. But let's get right into it by opening up, you guessed it, mix it up. I actually got a bit ahead of myself. The first thing you do is actually figure out what sound effects you want. So you essentially need to figure out what sound effects you want to play and what trigger words you want to use. Little John makes perfect sense, as he has, you know, very famous sound clips of him saying yeah and okay in his very particular voice. So that works, or even like TikTok sounds really work. But one website which I found super useful to find, you know, sound bites and everything like that is one called My Instance. This one. I didn't have the window open, is My Instance. So they've just got, you know, essentially buttons. You can choose whatever you want. So hypothetically, if you want this hello there by Obi-Wan sound effect, you can just either click the button to play it, or if you click the name, you can just download the MP3 from here. So this is a sound which we use for the Custom Entrance Sounds video, which I'll link over there if you want to learn how to set up custom entrance sounds. But yeah, this is a very simple website just for quickly downloading MP3s to set up. So you can essentially search for it. So hypothetically, if we search for Little John, Little John says okay, Little John long yeah, even what you could do. But yeah, so essentially download your sounds and figure out what trigger words you want to use. So that's step one. So I'm hoping you've sorted all that out. You've downloaded all the MP3s, you know what trigger words you want to use. You've put them in a nice little folder so you know where they all are. And now we're actually going to go into Mix It Up. So now that we're in Mix It Up, what we're going to do is we're going to create an action group. So we're going to go into our action groups. And then from there, you can see I've created like an auto response category, just so I have all those together. And I have a couple of action groups here. But for this example, let's just use, yeah, Little John. So I'm going to edit the command. And as you can see, it's just essentially playing a sound. We've got our sound file. It's going through our specific output device. And we've also got our volume controls here. One thing I would recommend with the volume controls is just testing the sound. So essentially just clicking the play button and just making sure that the sound isn't really, really loud. I know, especially from the My Instance website, some can be extraordinarily loud, whether that's the sound you want or not. But I would definitely recommend testing that because you don't want to blow your viewers' ears out, because that would just suck from their side. The last thing we want to do is we want to unlock the command, because essentially we want this to play whenever we want it to. We don't want it to request to play and then sit within any queue. So essentially just repeat this across all the sounds you want to automatically trigger. From there, we're going to save it. And now we're going to go into our commands, which is just our usual chat commands. And we're going to set up the trigger ones within here. So you can see here that we have the category of auto response, same one as we've used in the action groups. And then at the bottom here, we have all our sound commands. So if we edit the yeah, Little John one, and let's make this editor a bit taller. First thing we're going to do is we're going to run the command, and that's to play the sound. So that's that one we set up earlier. Next, with disable command, we're actually going to make it disable itself. Then we're going to wait. So 300 seconds, that's about 5 minutes. And then we're going to enable the command of this command. So essentially what we're making it do is we're saying, hey, play the sound, chill out for 5 minutes. So essentially acting as a cooldown, and then enable itself again. You can use the cooldown and the usage requirements up here, but then hypothetically, if someone triggers it without meaning to trigger it, you're just going to get all these weird cooldown messages within your chat, which just doesn't look that nice. In terms of how to trigger the command, that's what we've got up here. So essentially, since it's the yeah sound effect, we're just going to do YEA or YEAH. We're not going to do auto include exclamation marks, so we're going to make sure that's turned off. And then you can also use semicolons for multi-words. So essentially, if someone sends this or they send this, it will trigger this flow. We want to unlock the command. So again, it doesn't sit with any queue. It just kind of happens whenever the chat message is sent. Again, if it sits within a queue, it could happen a couple seconds later and it just seems like something went wrong. And the last thing, which is this one sitting in the middle, is wildcards. So having wildcard on means that MixItUp is going to read the entire chat message to find the trigger word. Meaning if the word sat within the start or the end of the message, that it would trigger. Turning it off means that it has to be at the start of the message in order for it to trigger. And you might be tempted to turn this on, but I wouldn't recommend it unless your trigger words are really, really niche. And for this example, rather than using yeah, I'm going to use the example of okay. So for the okay event, you would want either okay to be the trigger word or okay to be the trigger word. Now, if you sent a chat message to just okay, it would play the sound as essentially it's the only thing in the chat message and technically it's at the start of the message. If you send the message of okay, great, again, it would work as it sits within the start of the chat message. If hypothetically you turned wildcard on, if you said look over there, the word okay technically is within the word look. So since it's only looking for okay or okay, since okay exists within that chat message, it's going to play, which is not what you want, because for very common terms like okay and yeah, that can also be within other words, it's just going to be an absolute mess. So again, I'd recommend turning wildcard off unless your trigger word or trigger phrase is something very, very niche or something very, very long that can't accidentally be contained within another word or within a sentence, because that would just be a bit of a mess. But yeah, from there, essentially you have to do is save the command and then that's that. That's all set up. G'day everyone, Future Drew here. Just quickly jumping in just to let you know that you should do one more automation for this flow. The thing which you want to do is essentially add a manual override enable when you end your stream. So essentially make one action group that essentially turns on each of these auto react, auto response sound effects, and then trigger that action group within your end stream action. So essentially whether that be a button on your stream deck or within the stop streaming event within MixItUp. So what that will do is, let's say if someone automatically triggers one of these chat sound effects right before you finish streaming, right before you click stop streaming, that essentially it's going to go through, manually turn all of these back on once you finish stream, so it's all nice and reset and ready for when you next go live. But yeah, that's it from me. Back to the video. Now, for those of you that are a bit in doubt that this actually works, let's test it. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to send a message that says, okay, great.
Okay!
There it goes. Now, next I'm going to do a message that says, great, yeah. Doesn't send anything. Now I'm going to send a message that says, yeah, that's brilliant.
Yeah!
There it goes. So essentially, that's all working. So again, you don't really want wildcards turned on because you don't really want Lil Jon screaming in the background of your stream without anyone asking him to. But that's pretty much all for the tutorial. If you do want to support the channel and everything like that, you can like, comment, subscribe, and all that kind of stuff. But I know you've already done it because you are an absolute legend. But yeah, it's been me, Drew, your friendly neighborhood MixItUp ambassador, and I will see you next time. It's it. The finger guns have now evolved into a thumbs up, but